Second trick is to group your instruments and form an instrument rack. So it's like the split keyboard concept. You can separate your many octaves of keys in different zones. So your lower octaves play a bass instrument, middle octaves play another chord instrument, and your high octaves play a lead synth, for example. Unfortunately, there are no sends and returns in instrument rack, but you can always create another audio effects chain to emulate sends and returns. Here's our instrument rack. Inside there's three instruments. First, a bass. A synth chord. And a synth lead. They're all split into different zones, as you can see from the key zone settings. So naturally, the bass are the lower octaves, chords and leads are the higher octaves. The third method, resampling. So maybe ready-made loops are not your kind of thing. You want to play your own instrument, but instrument rack sort of limits your octave range. So you resample your instrument. So essentially, you are creating your own audio loops, which can then be hosted into drum rack. You can also resample a bunch of sounds, combining multiple tracks into one. Of course, there's no looking back, but it's not entirely a bad thing. In fact, some artists purposely resample their sounds to create something new. And it forces you to commit and work more efficiently instead of spending too much time just on one single sound. One simple trick to quickly extract loops from an instrument is through track freezing. You right-click on an instrument, freeze, and when it's done, you create a new audio track. And you just drag and drop. And there you go, your resampled loops, which you can then drag into drum rack if you want to, and delete the original instrument. And that's it for today. Next up, let us look into sidechaining. See you guys soon.